Really? machines, little poop poop puppies, little poop poop pants. Hey, poopers. Hey, little turd face. Oh, a little Eden. Little teddy bear Eden.
He's a sore bum. He needs like baby bum stuff.
Why
put on.
Look at
his
bum.
Look at his butt.
Oh, yeah. He needs baby wipes.
He needs some like Vaseline on there.
Yeah.
Some desiccant.
When can these guys go for sleepovers?
When they get their shots.
When's that?
When they finish their round of shots, I think they are around 12 weeks. Like once they're covered
in
rabies and stuff, yeah.
Cool.
Because
I'm stealing
heaters. Oh, so cute.
I just got an SUV this week with the main goal of I can
what
get more dogs
SUV
in it now.
What SUV did you end up getting?
I got a RAV4.
Oh, nice. Everybody loves those. Do you go for the hybrid or do you
just
the original?
No, just the...
Gas
car. I don't care. I go, is it big enough for bigger dogs? Yes. Done. I like it because the back gate is really low.
Yeah.
So when Goldie and everyone get really old, they can still get in. I already have all the seats down and like covers buckled over it. My friend was like, you bought this yesterday and already the back seats are just gone.
Yep.
We don't need them.
You don't need them.
It's for the dogs.
He's like,
pretty cool.
Yeah. She's like, yes. That one's Serena. Serena, this one?
Yep.
Serena.
Serena has a tennis glove on. It's the white just on her right toes, see?
Oh.
That's her tennis glove.
Mic's on. Which pup is Bolt? A black one with a penis. I haven't been able to tell them apart. I was just down there trying to figure that out. But I know that Misty has one of the hernia thing on her belly, umbilical hernia or something. So that's how I tell her apart from everybody else.
So how was your vacation?
My vacation was fun. I met, there's a lot of interesting people out there in Vegas.
Who'd you go with?
Huh?
Who'd you go with?
I went with Brian.
Oh.
Colleen and Sean were out there playing hockey. She does like hockey tournaments.
Oh.
So Brian and I flew out there, but it was a lot of fun. Brian's friends came down from California, and it was a good time. I was supposed to go on a helicopter ride over the Grand Canyon.
Ooh.
I know. But right before we went out, they canceled our ride because the wind was so bad. We watched one take off, and it was like, and I was like, are they supposed to always do that? Like, you would think, very smooth, and this is, like, wavelin' all around. So I'm kind of glad that we didn't get up there. Would have been a little scary.
Oh, those are good cookies.
Aren't they good? She gave me a whole basket. I've been passing them out all day. I've been shooting them out to everybody.
Oh, that's right. You had some basket over
yeah,
there.
It was a cookie basket.
I see.
Did you have a nice birthday? Yes, I did. Looks like Haydn is going to be a singer. Yeah, he's down there making some noise, but they'll quiet down.
You had one person email me.
Oh, it was Nico. Oh.
And tell me you're pronouncing it wrong.
Haydn? Haydn? Is it Haydn? I like Haydn. I think it's cute.
Whatever you say is the way it's going to be.
Yeah.
trying to explain to them that person should be around Janine for 20 minutes because she calls every animal by six different names. And yeah. They all know exactly what they're
doing. Exactly. Called. Linda noticed it the other day, today. I was outside with Orville, and she said, "Who's that?" And I said, "It's Redenbacher." And she goes, "Who?" And I was like, "It's Orville." And she's like, "Oh, okay." And she's talking to him. I was about halfway up to the Deagle House, and I was like, I just kept walking. I'm like, "Come on, Redenbacher." And he turns and trotted right up behind me. Yeah, I call Haydn or Haydn. I mean, I heard someone else saying Haydn, and I was like, "What?" So they all...
They understand what you're saying.
Yeah, they understand. How is Neko doing? Neko is doing fabulous. Her family loves her a lot. She's very spoiled. I'll try and share some pictures.
It's so easy to spoil a dog that's well-trained.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know?
It really
is. I mean, all
is.
These dogs, when they get out of here, they're well-trained.
Like, they behave really well.
And they behave well. They
even our
spoiled rotten.
Even our fabulous failures have a general amount of manners, which is nice. Oh, there. Yeah, Haydn, as in Eric Haydn. Oh, I don't know who that is.
Say it whatever you want.
Yeah.
You're not going to keep everybody happy.
I know, right? That's true. That is true. We'll never keep everybody happy. Let's see. What did you buy? You went out today. Did you have a detachable shower head or something?
Did.
We need to buy
one. Oh.
Next time
I got a thing from Costco saying that. That because I spend so much money there, which is, of course, it's George Myers.
Yeah.
That I have $870 worth of credit. Or
extra
whatever.
Stuff. Nice.
So I'm going to go buy a television, et cetera, for
that's
down
a great
there,
idea.
And a water thing.
Yeah.
And I don't know what I'll do with the rest of it. Maybe I'll buy cookies.
There you go. That's a great idea.
Yeah.
Discussion that Bolt vomited. Yeah, those puppies got wormed. Their bellies... aren't going to be that wonderful. He did throw up his dinner, but he ate most of it again.
Did he get wormed today?
Yeah, they all got wormed today. So.
So tonight will be very active.
There's a lot of diarrhea down there right now. So
a lot of diarrhea to start with.
It'll be, I'm not sure. You know, we've come across this before. I mean, it's also, obviously it's wonderful. We should worm them, but also maybe that they're getting too much food. Remember with the diarrhea?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Possible overfeeding. So we're going to try and find the happy medium for the food.
They're
and
certainly
then,
not thin.
Oh, yeah. We'll find a happy medium on the food, and I think that'll help with the vomiting. I honestly think that they just get so full because they get a good amount of food, and then it swells up even more once it's in the belly, and then I think it just causes them to just puke it all up again.
They just, last night, they all were.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you why. You're probably right, because they weren't running over to eat whatever the other guy threw up.
Yeah. They're just, like...
They're full.
Even down there today at feeding, like, they were just all like, oh, I guess we'll eat because we have to type of thing. And just sitting there, like, I walked away, I picked up poop, I came back, they were all just still slowly... I'm like, you don't have to eat it if you don't want to. So I wouldn't be surprised.
I mean, a horse. A dog should wolf down their food.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Dogs close to being matched. Yes. They seem to vomit when they get wormed. We have a dog. Washer will be in 2 weeks, hopefully, if she takes to her person. And then right after Washer, hopefully it'll be Kringle. She's coming up there with all the Italian cook chef
people.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Oh, good.
Yeah.
That's how you get a dog fast. Faster.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, the cook.
Yeah, the pups will be in Kennel 10 tonight. They'll be monitored through... the cams, so if there's any problems, who's your overnight, Grace? I believe
Grace,
it's Grace.
And then Sarah.
Yeah.
Beth.
Yeah. If for some reason we have a problem, they'll bring the puppy bus down. They won't try and run them up in the dark. So that will not wouldn't be fun. So, but I think they'll be fine. They seem very comfortable down there.
There's
five of them. I can pull. Oh, you don't want me to? It'll mess up the bandwidth, yep. Right? We'll check on them after. But yeah. Anyway, so yeah, we have some matches coming up. Big day for the puppies down in Kennel 10. Very exciting. Eating too fast, can that be it too?
I don't think so, eating too fast.
Not in this situation right now. I think when they're eating, normally when the puppies eat down there, their bellies suck in and they look super, super skinny while they're eating. A lot of the dogs down there, like the authors and everybody else, these guys...
They're already fat.
They come up with bellies like this big, and they don't go in when they eat, and they just seem to just blow up bigger and bigger. So I think it's a matter of too much. So we'll try and get in onto a better routine of even scoops to keep track of it, and then a spoon feeding, not too much canned food. Because even Shannon was like, "How much canned food should I go through down there?" And I was like, "Not, don't overdo it." Even little, because when I spoon feed them, I just do really like the tip of the spoon, unless I'm trying to get rid of it at the end and I give big mouthfuls to the big dogs. But for the most part, I just do a little bit. What do you always say? It's not quantity, it's quality.
It's frequency.
Yeah.
You can give a dog a tiny little piece of cookie and they're thrilled.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, so yeah, we will see what comes out of them all tomorrow. Be fun. Who's in the kennel next to them? It's Rocco, and then Gretchen, and then it's Charlotte, and Thor, and Edgar.
I drove down in there with my golf cart today, and there were five beautiful Harlequins, mm-hmm. right in a row.
Yeah, they're nice. That's out.
Nice looking dogs.
You got Harper, who's great. Pearl is a little timid. She's the next. Colleen's gonna try and once she gets her rabies shots and every. Or I think they might have already. Yeah, I don't know. Yes, they got the rabies shot. So Colleen's gonna start trying to get her out of her shell. She's very timid. So she's small, tiny. She looks like a mini Grey Dane. And then Edgar, big, isn't a tall boy. And then you have Bello, who looks just like Oscar. He has the mm-hmm. same patch on his eye.
But they're good looking dogs. Yeah. I wonder sometimes what the AKC show people think of our bunch of dogs.
I know.
Not that it's going to affect me in the slightest.
Yeah.
But when I first started this, and I had what I thought were good-looking dogs, and I like big square dogs, quarter horsey dogs. There's an AKC person that used to hound me about what junk I was breeding.
Yeah. I like them better.
Oh, just junk.
Yeah.
What on earth? Yeah, because they're good-looking dogs.
Yeah.
At least I thought so. And they're,
I still
they're
think
sad.
They are, yeah, nice and chunky.
But I'd go into that store with him, and she would come after me and say, "You shouldn't be breeding that dog. He doesn't have a championship on him." No, he doesn't.
Get a sticker that says champion and put it on his butt. what do you think of the mule? I like her. I think she's really friendly. I met her over at Janine's. It's interesting that her head is shaved.
I don't know why. She said all the mules were that way.
I know. Maybe it... My only thought was that the people that, you know how the, a lot of the Amish workers will bring, or the people will bring them in, drop them, and then get new ones. Maybe they shave them so they don't leave with the same one. Oh, don't take that one.
We've done that one.
We've had that one already. I don't know. How many pings did you get in Vegas thanks to your big brother, Steve? A lot. I saw that, and I put my phone on silent before I went to bed, so I didn't get woken up by it, but.
So how much did you lose in Vegas?
Oh, God. Why do we have to talk about it? A good amount. Nothing crazy. Not as much as my boyfriend's really into the table games, gambling, blackjack.
Look out for him.
Roulette, those type of things. So he knows when to walk away, but it shocks me how much money. It's expensive to even get in on a hand. I just watch. The table games are intimidating. I like the little penny 25-cent slot machines. That's my jam. I'll sit there.
Well, you look at those buildings out there.
Yeah.
And those buildings are not built with your winnings.
No. No, not at all. Those buildings are huge.
Like Hartford, Connecticut is built with your insurance money.
That's true. Bought all my TVs at Costco. They have the best warranties. So, if you look online, your dogs are beautiful compared to the champions. I think so. I'd really like to breed. If we bred Walter to Lainey, imagine the blocks we'd get out of those. Walter's blocky, and then Lainey's a little blocky girl, too. I wish she was a little taller, but that's all right.
Don't breed her to Walter. You might get some taller.
Yeah, yeah. So.
I don't know. If how many harlequin colors has Walter thrown? Does he always throw the pie balls.
Because the...
All his puppies are pie balls?
Yeah, because, well, people will argue that because they... the line with Olive... Was it Olive? Because we bred... It was when Walter was first starting out to be a stud dog, and he tied once, and then he couldn't do it again, so we panicked, and we threw somebody else in there, too. So there's two pie balls in that litter that look just like him, Logan and Mint.
Whoa.
But the rest are, like, blacks and... Harls, but it's written on there that they're Walter's dogs, but I mean it really doesn't matter. But and then when we bred him to Merlot, it was the Mantles. They look like Mantles. That's like Gabby,
yeah.
Zeke, Grommet.
Yeah.
I don't know if you'd necessarily call
them.
Have
you ever thrown a real spotted one?
No, because we bred him to Noel again.
Mm-hmm.
And we got all the ones that look like Sizzle and Podrick and
yeah.
Brad and Ned. They all look the black and white.
I wonder how that works into that chart they have of colors.
Yeah. Like if you bred him to a Harl. Because he's completely covered in black spots, but his hair is white. But when you wet him down, I'll have to do it one day. We'll lock this guy up. We'll bring Walter in here and we'll hose him off. Somehow we'll get a tarp. And you'll be able to see, he has black spots all over his body. Yeah, completely spotted. But his white hair grows out and covers it all. I remember when he was a little.
Interesting.
And the first time I gave him a bath, I was like, oh my gosh, he's covered in spots. He looked like a little, like a Harl, with all little tiny spots. More like
spots, yeah.
Like these ones.
Freckles.
Yeah, little freckles.
Is he the one that's putting freckles on the front legs of some of those dogs? Are those his children?
Not Spinner. You thinking Spinner with the real spotted legs?
Yeah,
that's he's. Well, I mean, yeah. I guess he's Grommet, isn't he? Grommet.
Oh, I got puppy.
Oh, stop it! You're fine. Stop it.
Oh, stop it.
Stop it. Come here. He's saying no. Stop. Come on. You know what
some
no
of
means?
Those are fat, fat dogs.
See what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah, they're fat.
They have too much food.
Ben, are you quiet? Quiet.
Oh. Sit, Sparkle, you're fine. Stay there. I got her. Don't worry.
That's not your mother.
You be quiet.
That's not your mom. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're bothering the old dog. She got a bunch of grumpy Gusses in here. All right. Oh, you're late for mail call.
Have you been taking them on mail? Megan, no, you haven't been here.
No, but I've been I worked on it down there, but we got to do more. I like now that they're in.
Right. You got to keep them together better.
Yeah.
Because nobody is around here. They're all over the place.
They're everywhere. Yeah. I noticed. We'll work on it. I'll get it under control.
I was trying to get around here for them to carry the can and feed every 10 feet.
Nobody gets that, though.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have to yell and scream, and then you're the bad
yep.
guy. All right, we'll do that tomorrow. I'll try and get it in morning and afternoon.
That would be good. All right, now what are we doing? Did you call for food?
I did. So now you can get a card that we have.
Oh, yes, okay.
So?
Do they know what time we would like it delivered? Is that the way that goes nowadays?
No, they tell us.
Oh, they tell us?
Yes.
I bet you could call it at noontime and say, would you please deliver it at 5:30 or something?
Oh, know. Yeah, you could do that, but right now it's a...
Yeah, the other way around.
David, you do a meal call?
Sure.
I'll bring you one. Will you give that to the person?
Okay. I'm back right here. I better go the other way there. There we go. I'll go this way. There we go. I got to put Galena on now.
Hi.
No, hi.
Oh, that's my newspaper.
Look at your
hiding. I could really cancel that.
I know,
that edition of the Wall Street Journal. I do read it online. I think I could save the paper end of it. And I also took a thing out to the New York Times. Yes. Yes, they also put online 10 things you're supposed to know today. So I do that. That's what I call myself, educated, and I quit. Okay, here we go. Stacy.
Everybody go to sleep.
Plantsville, Connecticut.
Okay.
Attention, Carlene or Linda? Something. Since I'm Carlene, I'll open it. I'll open it anyway. Uh-oh. What is this for? I can't read. Here, you read the bottom. You see what's on the bottom of that envelope?
Carlene or Linda, lead for Pixie.
Lead? Did I send them already? I must have.
Check.
Wow, okay. I'll do that. She's the one that wanted these chain ones. These chain things back here?
Stacy. Yeah? Oh, she sent you a check?
Yeah, she did.
Okay.
And the reason they're expensive is those chains. Even though they've been donated to us, the chains are expensive. So it's not like you're ordering a piece of rope. In memory of Maureen Curley. Isn't that wonderful? Thank you. This is Janet Barnes, Boxford, Mass. Wish she had friends from all over. Oh, right. This is from somebody in Wakefield.
What was from Janet?
Huh?
What was from Janet that she sent?
Check what. What did she say?
Yeah, what did she send?
A check.
A check for bricks?
No, as memory of.
Oh, okay.
Didn't I just do that one?
I didn't hear.
Oh, crying out loud. How would you pay attention? Don't expect me to remember two minutes later. I can't remember either. Okay. Moving on. It's me, Seamus. The big furry boy in the picture. Hope you don't mind that I'm a cat. I'm writing to you because I have a problem. I'm wondering if you could help me. Ever since Mama heard about Service Dog last month, she's been spending a lot of her computer time watching what she calls puppies. She says they're cute and fun to watch. However, it's taking time away from spending time with me, the cat. So, Carlene, what should I do about this? Any advice you can give me, we greatly appreciate it. You should learn to bark. Erf, erf. See, then you'll be all set. Mama says she loves what she calls fireside chats. I wonder what she'd call them when the fireplace is no longer needed. Enclosed her a couple dollars for the fun. Thank you very much. So that's Seamus from Wakefield. That's why I couldn't read it. Look at the green eyes on that cat. Wow. There you go. You got it?
Mm-hmm.
So I'll throw this one out. I didn't. I'll just throw that out. Okay. Here we have, probably, oh, this is Mary Hilliker from Southington, Connecticut. We have a couple people in Southington, Connecticut. Every time I see Southington, Connecticut, I think it's a certain person, and it's somebody else. We must have a couple people there. Okay, dear Carlene. Okay, put that in there. Enclosed a check for 2 chicken bricks in memory of Maureen Curley in honor of Karamia's service to her. God bless you, and I hope the AEIG check clears. So do I. Between potholes and electrical poles, life at Crazy Acres is never dull. Thanks for all changing lives. Sassy Bell, who's Mary. Okay, so that being a chicken brick, and she's got her address on it, that can go in there, and you can have that. We have fewer puppies with us today because the others are down in the barn.
They're staying there?
in kennel 10. Mm. What on earth? Get the card accepted every major gas station. Well, we get rid of that one quick. But we... bit of that thing. Okay. Next. Next we have Leahy Medical Center. That's not anything that's going to be opened. That's another one. They haven't gotten something down. Oh, here we go. Here we go. I'm going to have those scissors out here. I don't know who steals my scissors. Somebody takes them all the time. This is from Laura Foster, Schenectady, New York. Schenectady, New York. The other way up. Other way up. Dear Carlene, thank you for all you do for both people and dogs. You help so many. Enclosed is $10 for a chicken brick and a monkey fix, please. And thanks to all those fantastic volunteers. Silent CP since Okies Pokies in 15. Well, thank you very much. We'll do that. And she gets two chicken bricks. So that... she doesn't have her address on there. I better put the two here. Mm. Nothing. Put a point in. Two. I'll put that in there because that's got her address on it. And then... what am I supposed to do with this? Give it to you. And then it really does help if you get things down off here because I can't turn. I don't turn so good.
How many?
What did she say, two?
I'm not sure.
I can't remember. Okay, let's put that here. Let me come back to see. I think it was one. Oh, you got the letter.
I got the letter.
What'd she say?
Let's see. Ten for a chicken rig and a monkey fist.
Okay, we got it. We got it. With a bunch of poker chips just for the hell of it. Next. Feels like this is a chicken brick or two. I mean, whatever they are. You can have that one. It feels like there's something in there, though. You better look. Any job worth doing is worth doing well. Whoop. And that's just what you did. Thanks so much. I'd like two chicken bricks. Okay, and she said a money order. Okay, well that works. We can do that. Okay, so she's got to have... okay, so we got to have... I need more. You got to get a supply of these. We're going to put about five or six down here on my level. Arena from Toronto. It's not easy, is it?
No.
I'm only going to put two poker chips in there because God knows what will happen if we try and get them through state, through customs. Okay, so I need to seal that because that's not sealed. What happened to the package stuff? package sealer. I don't know where it is. This cannot go without some tape on it. I had a roll. This serious needs tape.
Mm-hmm.
There's purple over there, duct tape, that would work. I'll keep going here. Let's see if that works. That ought to work, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think that stuck out a little bit. There we go. Okay, so that's ready to go. Next. I see this. They don't have one there. You know? See, the other things have a post that comes out there.
Yep.
So there's some place to hang it. Have one there.
Change the design, don't
you? Oh dear, such tribal troubles. Okay, Shannon, white. Bolton, Mass. Memory of Maureen Curley. This is from Bolton, Mass. I tell you, in memory of all over the place. And this is from Ronald Pajanowski from Albany, New York. You better look inside there. And this one says, three chicken bricks. And postage for the fund. Mailer for you do a great job. Keep up the good work. Okay, so we need three chicken bricks, so that's got to go in there. Mm-hmm. And this guy wants some poker chips. Mm-hmm. A couple of bows. Down here. Don't bother counting the poker chips you get because I just grabbed some. There is no prescribed amount. There. Stay there. Don't you fall off. It didn't. There. Okay, so here we go. Patricia Osborne, Lincoln, Nebraska. That's a ways away. I went out there once to buy donkeys along Route 80. There you go. I purchase chicken bricks on your website. I'd love to have monkey fit. I read the doggy daily every morning. Nothing better than starting a day with a smile and a laugh. Uh-oh, I've done something wrong. Here we go. Now what happened? Service Dog Project. Who's calling? Amy? Oh, my God, I get so annoyed at that stuff. Hi, this is Amy. Who is Amy? I'm from Auto Care Services.
Oh, nice.
Your Toyota. I'll never buy another Toyota at this rate, I'll tell you. There was one day I had 6 phone calls in one day. Now, do you know that your Toyota is about to get out of its whatever it is?
Yeah, yeah.
So So therefore, you should pay $129. You could have another 3 days worth. Or I don't know what they're after.
Your money, pretty much.
Money, that's right. That's
they're
right.
Not, you know what they are? They're outside of the dealerships.
Yeah.
They know somehow that the warranty's running out on the vehicle, so these outside companies start calling.
Yeah.
So it's not Toyota.
No.
We get the same things. Kind of for our Jeep, they kept calling for a Jeep we didn't even have anymore.
What will happen if you start telling these people, fine, you'll take this, and you give them an absolutely fake credit card or whatever.
Hmm.
You ask them to send you a whole bunch of brochures. Somehow, if you could get them to spend money on you,
right,
that would not be a bad idea. Maybe ask you to send me all your stuff, and then I'll look at it. Okay. I didn't say who this was from, did I?
Nope.
Let me read it. Kathy, Carmel, New York. I wonder, Kathy in Carmel, New York, you wouldn't happen to know a Bobby Devereaux, would you? Barbara Devereaux? Very good friend of mine. One of my high school friends. I'm pretty sure she's Carmel, New York. Thank you for all you do. Watching the camera has been my new hobby. Drives my husband nuts. Please keep it up. I need 3 chicken bricks. Also, they only charge 1 handling fee for calendars, so an extra $10 for that. Thank you very much, Kathy. We'll do this. You need some chicken bricks. That can go in there. And it's got her name and address on it, doesn't it? Yeah. We'll figure it out. Okay, and so she...
I'm out of them again, see? I'm out.
Again?
I'm out.
She keeps giving them away.
No. I make a lot of... I'm really under pressure now. I've got another 10 in the bedroom here. I haven't... This is the other variety, you know. It's the big one. Let me just put a bunch of that. Thank you. Yeah, Kathy, if you know Bobby or you look her up, she reads the Daily Doggy every day. I know she does. Because I watch her. She's one of my high school friends. Bobby Devereaux. She doesn't live in Carmel. She lives pretty damn close to it. There you go. She's all ready to go now. Okay. And here we have American Girl. Okay, we got rid of that one. Keller and Fleming. Pinwheels, New York? Wow, I never heard of that place. This is our diabetic dog. Or else she's a very slow lapper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what do we got in there? Anything, nothing in there. Okay. Here we have Killeen. It's almost Carleen. Killeen. Killeen Fleming, Syracuse, New York. Enclosed is a posted page, self-addressed, padded for poker chip and monkey fist. Please use the enclosed money wherever needed. Just a little something extra after getting our chicken bricks online. Look at those $2 bills. Thank you again for allowing us to be a little part of all you do, allowing us the privilege of watching the goings-on through your cameras at explore.org. Amazing group, 24/7. Blessed may all the people and animals of service dog forever and always be. Huh. Okay.
You know, we probably keep the $2 bill department going if the mint.
We have them all separated.
I know.
We have a year.
But where they make them.
Oh, yeah, right.
There's, we get so many sent here. They're keeping the demand.
Somebody said, So I don't have to put her in there for chicken bricks. Here, you check, make sure it doesn't say anything about chicken bricks. Okay. Okay.
Nope, they got their chicken bricks online.
Okay. There we go. We got. I put in too many poker chips, the postage goes up like crazy. But that's okay. She gave us a lot of postage. Don't do that. All right, so now we got this stuff. Now I'm going to open that up. And this is from... somebody. Boy, they have small print on this. Printed in Canada. Delivered to Service Dog Project. Huh, okay, well, we see what happens, I guess. Oh, shush.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. I gave away my last business card today, so this is new business cards.
Huh.
And we'll save that good box for puppies. That's a good puppy box.
Yeah.
Puppies are sleeping. It's a good thing.
Let me just check and make sure these are what we thought they were going to be.
Yes, it is.
Oh, wow. Okay. Business cards say, live cams of Great Danes 24/7, 365. All phases of becoming service dogs. Go to our web, and then email is my address. Watch our puppy cams on explore.org. Open house every Sunday, 37. That's pretty good. That's got everything we need.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I can put one of those back in here. There'll be a slight delay while I organize my desk. It isn't terribly organized anyway. Oh, my word. Oh, I have other things in here I forgot about. Oh, boys. Oh, boys. They're going to go. They're going to go in there. There we go. Than these, I think it was, is it Bella and George? But Bella and George had cards made.
Yeah.
And I have a couple extra Shatterpot. Yeah, there are a couple extra weird things in there. Okay. Who's making that noise over there?
One of the puppies.
Okay, there we go. This is not from that part, it's from this part. Elaine, from Hancock, Maine. From Hancock, Maine. Here we go. Oh, a goodie box.
Mm-hmm.
A goodie box, here we are. You put that back on the wall now, we don't need it anymore. Canine Curios. Okay. Oh.
And nose.
Oh, look at that. Oh, those are bad. Oh, they're all these pralines.
Praline, yep.
Chocolate cream filling. Oh, God. Okay, and some more Lifesavers. I was amazed. I had somebody out yesterday with no Lifesavers in their car. Okay, so we're got, and that's a dog thing. We'll put that dog thing over there. Everything else, oh dear. Everything else is Steve's and mine. Those are all candies. Even on the carry-out thing.
It's going underneath her.
She'll get it. You watch.
Yeah, eventually.
Okay. So we're all done with that. And that's got to go in the other. Well, there's more.
There's one more.
One more. You got to get this one out of here first. I'm ready. Mail. Somebody.
Go lay down.
It doesn't say who.
Go lay down.
Get out of here. Go lie down. Go.
Oh, she found it.
Oh, good. Okay, and we did that, and we did that, and we did this. See what we got.
That at least seems to think it's something else.
Oh! I'm sending in memory of Maureen Curley. Oh, those are those medical things.
Oh,
uh-huh. Okay. The stuff they use in operating rooms and
right.
Things. Those are nice to have. By Lord, they're nice to have. We have a bunch of them. Isn't that wonderful? Those are great. Those are great. Thank you.
Where are they from? Do we know?
I don't know who they're from. I knew who they were from, didn't I? It didn't have a name. They're in memory of Maureen Curley, but it doesn't say who she is.
What are those called?
National Museum of the American Indian. Somebody closely related to the American Indians. Okay. Bud has joined us.
What happened?
That you've joined us for cocktail hour?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
I did.
Did I put my scissors? Don't go in there. I don't have enough scissors. What'd you say?
Squeaky chair.
We're ready. Okay.
Over there.
We got the free chicken bits, didn't we?
Yes.
We do. Okay. So we didn't make any mistakes today at all?
Not that I know of.
Not yet? Okay.
They'll tell us.
You people read so fast.
I'm not reading. I'm just trying to find the beginning.
Oh, okay.
Where Megan left off. This is hard for me to read where it's so spread out. I like to, when it's more compact.
I don't know how to do that.
Well, you have to have the camera on. That's the only way, really. I don't want to leave anyone out. Uh-oh. Here we go.
Massachusetts. Service Dog Project. Hi, Gary. That's normal. Yeah, they all have this throwing up thing. I think they're eating an awful lot. They've been wormed. No, that's always nice to get. We will write it down on the blue chart in the kitchen. Okay. Thanks. Bye bye. Yep, bye. Somebody can kennel 10 is throwing up and the other one's eating it. And I said, oh, that's normal. It's normal except when did they have their worming medication?
I don't know.
Because if she's throwing up the worming medication and the other guy's eating it, then the other guy's getting twice. So we probably ought to put that down on a puppy in kennel 10 throwing up and somebody else is eating it. That's all we know.
What should I do?
Write it on the, there's a blue blue piece of paper over there, blue chart, over the dishwasher. That's where you make all medical notes.
Okay, SDP dogs are regal and elegant because they are so solid and with beautifully shaped heads, and all the more beautiful because they are well trained and serve such an important mission. Did KRLA win free cat litter? I don't know what that is.
I don't know if that's that Toyota thing.
Oh, no, I think it's something else they've been voting for on the chat. Yeah, we got the Toyota thing. I heard
did
that.
We?
Yeah.
We won it?
We won it.
Good. How did you know we won it?
How did I know? I saw it on the chat this morning, I think.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Surprise.
Did you find the place?
Here we go. Okay.
You can write it anywhere on there.
Okay. Here from Blue Penguin. Dearest Carleen, did you see that STP, thanks to the CP family, won the Toyota of Braintree 500 Smackers?
Wonderful.
Yes.
Okay. Wonderful. Thank you very much, everybody.
It's official. What are the dog cots and the kennels called? What size do you have for the dogs, and where can I get one?
Okay. The Carandas.
Carandas.
The Carandas. And we don't have the very biggest.
We don't.
No. Because if you get the very biggest around here, people sleep on them. They don't hold people well.
Yeah. Trampoline size.
By the time you get a dog and a person, they just don't hold up well at all. But they do really well with just a dog. And the dogs love them.
She says, my sister has a black lab that would like one. So what we have here is probably the right size.
They're not the extra large. It's probably large.
Did I hear that Carleen got a check from AIG?
Yes, I did. It's already deposited. I went right to the bank with it. Uh-huh. It hasn't cleared yet. They said give them 5 days for it to clear.
I think you may have some St. Patrick's Day cards coming.
Oh, good.
Someone asks, what are they doing for the memorial gift? What it is people are sending in gifts for
Maureen. They're donating money.
Right, donating money in memory of Maureen. What was her last name?
Curly.
Curly. Maureen Curly. Hey, David, Tanner's young, nimble fingers pick those monkey fists right off. Yeah, I bet they do. Should have got Nico in here to get them.
Jeez, look at that. They're almost up there again.
I don't think I know her.
One of the pups in kennel 10. I can read that one.
Yeah, I'm trying to read this one. I don't know her, but I would love to meet her. If she is anything like you, maybe I can bring her for a visit. Not sure
what
that
means. I
can't hear
what you're saying, sorry.
It says, I don't know her, but I would love to meet her. If she is anything like you, maybe I can bring her up for a visit. I'm not sure what they're talking about. Saw Giselle, made a visit to Kennel 10.
Really?
Yep. No, Kennel 11, I'm sorry. Kennel 11. One of the pups just vomited. Bolt again, not cleaning it up this time.
Here's Bentley.
Here's Bentley, yep. Bentley heard K9 and immediately got up off the futon and headed for the goodies.
Hmm.
Nice gift. Surgical towels are great. I'm missing Miss Sizzle, so I bet Carlene is too. Is she adjusting okay, okay to being confined to the laundry building in Honeymoon Hill?
She's not happy.
Yeah, they usually
aren't
happy.
She's not happy, but I did go down and give her one of those sliced bones, those sliced bones we have.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a plain sliced bone. What do they call them? Sliced knuckle bone? We got a bunch of them. They're about half inch, three quarters inch thick.
Yeah.
So she'll work on that for the whole day, I think.
She's telling us again we won. Aaron's doing fine. Probably won't be here.
Hmm? Where is he?
So he's asking. At home.
Oh.
Bolt is throwing a beating at himself. A lot of vomit comments. Mo is a nice mule. She has had someone work with her in the past. She must have been a working mule, huh?
Oh, she's a working mule.
Yeah.
She's a working mule. She's not been anybody's pet because she doesn't know, she doesn't understand hand feeding. And with a great deal of effort today, we got her to eat a half an apple.
Oh.
But she wouldn't take it out of her hand. We had to put it in her feed box. And she played with it enough so she finally ate it.
What is the status of buying Mo?
We own her? We own her. Technically, I think at the moment I've paid for her, which is fine.
Uh-huh. Someone likes our square dance with the stools and the tables here. How is Mo doing?
She's doing very nicely. I let her out this afternoon, walked around. She ate out of the frying pan. She's beginning to recognize the frying pan. Second time she comes out, she walks around the manure pile and pees in it.
Huh.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah. It's like a litter box for horses.
Right, so we must remember to let her out every day.
Yeah. Oh, we have a picture of the...
Picture of the vomit coming?
The vomit, yep.
Isn't that good? He put it right on the side. Isn't that good?
Well, oh, here we go. Let's go see. That's it. Hope the pups in 10 come into the house so they can get some food, especially the vomiting pup. They ate.
They ate.
They had dinner down there. Mule that won't eat out of your hand is a plus in my book.
Is it what?
A plus. Since the power stuff was happening last Wednesday, we missed our favorite squint. Y'all go nom nom and dearest Carlene go night night and huge penguin hugs to all SDP and my CP family too. Bright green eyes on Seamus the cat. Oh, that was due to the flash of the camera hitting the eyes. It was a nice effect. Have you heard from Melissa today?
No.
She won't be here all week, right? I think
something
I heard.
Like that.
Yeah. Where was the dryer being moved this afternoon? It was on Puppy Hill.
That's the electric dryer that we took out of the feed room so that we could move in the gas dryer. The gas dryer not using nearly the electricity that the electric dryer uses just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
We already have gas in the feed room because of the furnace being there. So by getting rid of the electric dryer there, we pretty much cured the problem in that whole area, I think. We'll know. Is that right, Bud?
I would say so, yeah.
Yeah. See, Bud thinks so.
I certainly believe it, yeah.
Well, food is here.
Okay.
So there are no more questions right now, so I think we should wrap it up.
Bye.
Say goodbye. Bye. Have a good night.
Camera.
Thank you for everything.